to Chefdin Academy, and today I'll be showing you how to cut a section from a slab detail. This is a typical solid slab detail, and I'm going to cut a section along a particular axis and show you how to do it. If you have not subscribed to this channel, kindly do so, as I will be making more videos on structural engineering and civil engineering at large. So let's get started. This is a typical slab, solid slab detailing. You can see we have the main reinforcement. They are the ones in red color. They are the bottom reinforcement, and we also have the top reinforcement in green color, as you can see. So to draw a section, I come to home here. Then I will change my layer to, I've created a layer for section line. So I click on section line. Then you come to line here, I pick line. Then you can cut your section at any point on the slab. So the purpose is just to show how the detailing goes. So let's say I cut my section along here, then I have something like this. Then I have something like this. So to now show this section, let me now come to draw. Then you click on construction line. Then you click on vertical. You type V, then enter for the construction line. So let me change this to beam. Structural beam, yes, I have structural beam here. So let me come back to draw, then construction line, press V, enter. Then let me change the thickness to default. I have that, so V, enter. Then so you click on the beams. So I have another beam here, and I have another beam here. So you can see that this is the section that I cut the section along this line. So that means I can only view this beam here and this beam here. So on doing that, then I now need to draw a line. So I'm going to offset. You now offset the thickness of your slab from my design. The thickness of my slab is 150, so I will offset 150, enter, then offset. Then you also offset your beam. The beam is 450 from the design, so offset 450. So I have this. Then you now trim out your beam, your slab and the beam combination. You trim it out. So I just have this. So I click here, then I click here, then I click on this beam too. I click here, and I click here, and I stop it here. So I just delete all these lines that I drew before. I hope you understand. So this is the section of the beam. Now the next thing is now to arrange our reinforcement. So for you to start arranging your reinforcement, depending on the cover that you are using. So let's say we are using a cover of 25. So I just draw a line just to indicate, then I will press 25. My cover is 25, so this is the cover. So let me just copy this and paste it on the other edge of the beam. So I will paste it here. Yes. So the next thing you are now going to do is, since I'm cutting a section here, you are just going to copy all the, let me move it up a little bit so that we can see. Let me move it up a little bit. Yeah. So you can see that this reinforcement is spanning, if you check the call out here, is spanning from from here to here. So this reinforcement will be seen on the section. The same thing goes for this reinforcement. We'll be seeing it on the section. So let me first of all put the reinforcement that will be seen on the section. So I will click on this, click on the reinforcement, click on the top reinforcement to, then you click on this, you click on this to, I hope you are getting it, you click on this to, you click on all the reinforcement that can be seen. Then I will now copy it to the section that I've cut, then click here, then I will copy to this place. So this is it. You can see now, that's it. That's the first one. Then for the second one, you see that there are some beam at the top here for the top reinforcement. For the top reinforcement, you have this green bar at the top. So I just copy it like that. So I copy, then I come and paste it. Let me just paste it here because I've not indicated my slab, my cover. So I will now offset my cover of 25 mm. So here, then I can now delete this. So this is my top reinforcement. You can see that I have done the detailing. So the next thing now is I've shown this reinforcement. I cannot show this reinforcement because this reinforcement is stopping here, and this is where I cut my section, so I won't be seeing it. I hope you understand. So I won't be seeing the reinforcement. So, but I'll be seeing, for me to now see this reinforcement now, this reinforcement will be seen as a cycle in the section. So I just come to a cycle. Let me just indicate with a cycle. Then let me use it to be, let me use the diameter of cycle to be 8. I just enter the radius, so that's 8. So I have this as my circle. So let me now hash it. Let me make it a red color. Let me make it red. Let me make it since I have bottom and top reinforcement, I make it bottom reinforcement. Then I will now hash it with red color. Ash H for ash. So I pick solid, then I pick my color to be red. So I just arch inside. I hope you get. Then you now copy this reinforcement. Copy. Then I copy from the center. I need the center. I pick the center. So let me just off this perpendicularity. I off it. Then you place it here. So I have it here. So the next thing that you now need to do is you need to get the spacing of the reinforcement. This is the reinforcement that I picked, that I just made, is this reinforcement and this reinforcement. The spacing is 300, so I just put it at a spacing of 300. I hope you are getting it. I put it at a spacing of 300 like that. So where is the yes, this is it. So I just copy, then CO for copy, then I press enter. So I will on the perpendicularity. So 300, enter, 600, enter, 900, in multiple of 300, enter, 1002, enter. Let me stop like that. So the next thing that I'm now going to do is I'm now going to copy this this reinforcement. I just copy it like this. Copy, then I will, I've highlighted it, then I will copy it from here. Sorry, I will not highlight the last one. So I will just copy this four. Then I will copy it from the center of this one. So I copy it from here, then I will paste it so that I will not be typing over and over again. So I paste it here. Where's the last one? So I paste it here too. My whole of my reinforcement is 300 mm center to center, so I place it here too. Then I place it here too. So I place it where again? I place it here also. So I place it here also. And yes, I think that's all. So I'm going to delete this one because the reinforcement will not actually reach this side. So then I'm going to move this one. I'm moving it from this edge. Yes, let me move it from. Sorry, I should have moved everything to this place. Then I will move M for move. Then I put it here. Yes. So I have this. So let me now offset this one. Copy this one at a spacing of 300 also. 300. So I have this. So this is my reinforcement. Then for the top reinforcement also, you can see that the top reinforcement, this reinforcement here is distributed by this reinforcement here. So I need to indicate this one. It is also this reinforcement that is distributing this reinforcement. So I need to indicate it. It's also the same reinforcement that is distributing this top reinforcement here. So I need to indicate it. So to do that is very easy. So I just come here. What is the spacing of the reinforcement? The spacing is 300 also. So I just come here. I will copy this. I will copy it and I'm going to paste it here. Then I will change the color. Since it's a top reinforcement, so it's going to be the color of a top reinforcement. So where is my top reinforcement? Yes. So I'm going to match property to this color. Here you can now see. So the next thing is I'm now going to give it a spacing of 300. Spacing of 300. So 300. 900. No, 600. 600. 900. So let me just stop that 3. So I think we only have 3 reinforcements here. So let me delete it. Then for this side too, the distribution bar. So I will copy this reinforcement again. I will copy this reinforcement. I'm going to copy this one too. So I'm just going to come here and paste it. So I'm pasting it. Let me remove the perpendicular. So I'm pasting it here. Yes. So now for the other side, let me just copy these two reinforcements. Then I will on the perpendicularity. CO for copy and so I copy it here. I will copy it here. Then paste it here. And I think I'm done. So this is the top reinforcement for this one. Then for this one also, it undergo the same process. So let me just copy these 3 reinforcements. So I don't need that. So let me copy these 3 reinforcements. I copy it. CO for copy. I copy it at this edge here. So I will come here and paste it here. So let me just off the perpendicularity so that I can have, yes, paste it here. So this is my typical slab section detail. So the next thing that I just have to do is I just have to label my reinforcement. It is very easy. It is just the beam that you indicated that you are going to label. For example, I indicated this one. So I'm just going to copy this and let me remove the perpendicularity. It's removed already. So this is the bottom reinforcement. And also I have this reinforcement that was spanning it. I have this one, so I just copy it to along the x-axis. So that will be the red reinforcement that I was seeing as circle. So let me just put it here and let me rotate. R0 R O plus for rotate. Let me on the perpendicularity. So I rotate it like that. So I have this. So let me move up. So let me just stay. Yeah, so I have that. Then the other reinforcement that I have is I have this reinforcement, but I don't put the label for this reinforcement. So let me just use this label, copy, and I want this. So let me, I have this, yes. So let me just copy this reinforcement, copy here. So this is the label for this reinforcement. Then for the circular reinforcement that we can see as circle here, so this is the label for it. It is this reinforcement that was spanning through. So this is going to be the label for it. So just copy the label and so I copy it. So let me paste it here and let me just rotate. So and on the perpendicularity, as we can see, just like that. So let me now move. Let me off the perpendicularity, then paste it. Yeah, yes, I have this. So these are my reinforcements. So this is a typical way of sectioning your detailed slab. Thanks for listening. Subscribe, kindly subscribe to my channel, like and comment.